Guys, welcome to the Massive Iron Channel. I'm Steve Shaw, editorial director at TigerFitness.com and Muscle & Brawn Nutrition CEO. Guys, this is hashtag AskBHUD, the big hairy ugly dude. Yes, the big hairy ugly dude. And I got a question from Instagram on, can I provide some tips on building muscle on a limited budget? Yes, I can. I'm going to get into that in this video. Before I do so, guys, if you have a question for me, check out the information below. You can hit me up on Instagram or Twitter. Post your question along with hashtag AskBHUD, and I will try to answer your question in a video. So I'm driving home from Memphis, so excuse the background noise. But a gentleman, a follower by the name of Mars23, who has been following me for a while on Instagram, and I appreciate his support, asked me for tips on bodybuilding on a budget. First off, my biggest tip would be find a gym that is cheap, that is cost effective. Look, I know everybody hates on Planet Fitness, but if I didn't have a lot of money, guys, and I had to only pay $10 a month or whatever, I'd be working out at Planet Fitness. But the cornerstone is not worry about gym. Find an inexpensive gym. $10, $15 a month, find some deal. Because you can make do at any gym, even if you're not using the most optimal exercises. Oh my God, yes, you can't squat or deadlift at Planet Fitness. But you know what? You aren't always in a period of your life where you're thriving. So if I had a limited budget and I had to work out at Planet Fitness, I'd be doing barbell rows. I'd be doing dumbbell rows. They don't have heavy dumbbells. So what? Do rest pause. Do high rep work on dumbbells. Do what it takes. There's always a way to challenge yourself. And again, the main point here that we're trying to stress is that we're working with a limited budget. So save money on a gym. Find a gym that at least has dumbbells and barbells and a quality mix of machines where you can get in a good workout. And you can find exercises and find ways to challenge yourself in that environment. So let's say you have a gym membership and you want to know how to eat good on a budget. Look, it's pretty easy. My cornerstone number one is eggs. You can buy 18 eggs for, you know, God knows what, $1.50. Each Sunday I go to the store and buy a bunch of eggs, 36 eggs, and I boil them, and that's my, I use those throughout the week. So I get about, what do we got? About five to six eggs a day between how, you know, depending on how much I eat. That's about 40 grams of protein right there per day. And that's pretty inexpensive. I also do things like there's a flapjack protein pancake mix. I can take a pack of that, which costs like $5 or $6. And all you do is mix it with 2 scoops of whey and 3 1/4 scoops of water, and I have this recipe on my page on Instagram, and it makes 12 squares that are 100 calories each and 17 grams of protein each. So it makes about 200 grams of protein for only $5. That's a huge budget thing. So there are these protein pancake mixes out there for $5, $6, $7 that you can use as well. Another thing is meal prep. What I'll do is I'll make a crock pot meal. I'll get, you know, 3 pounds of turkey or whatever's on sale, ground turkey, ground chicken, ground hamburger, whatever's on sale. You can throw chicken breasts in the crock pot. Whatever meat is cheap and on sale, I throw that in the crock pot with like a diced onion, with a couple diced peppers, whatever vegetables are cheap, and I put in a little bit of water and season that stuff, you know, with salt and pepper and, you know, soy sauce or hot sauce or whatever. You know, you got to season it, but you can put that in the crock pot. You can get $10 to $15 worth of meat and make, you know, 10 meals from that, 10 meals that have 30 to 40 grams of protein. So there you have already have 5 to 6 eggs per day, a couple of protein squares. I call them, you know, blondies are not brownies, but you can put them in a baking pan or put them in a muffin pan. You can make muffins or blondies. You know, between the eggs and those and this crock pot meal, you already have like 120 grams of protein, and we haven't even spent that much money. You also I strongly recommend getting 5 pounds of whey protein because you get like 60 to 70 servings of protein for only about $50. That's a huge bargain. You can use a couple of them a day. It's a buck or two per day, and all, you know, throw that in the mix. Your grams of protein are already up to 170 per day just from those meals. You got the eggs, you got the the protein pancakes mix and muffins or blondies. You have your meal prep or your lunch prep that you did. You have a couple of protein drinks. You can also get a couple things of Greek yogurt each week that have at least 20 grams of protein per serving. You can eat that with a half scoop of whey mixed in or some fruit mixed in. That's also very good for the budget, and that adds like 20 to 30 grams of protein. You can eat that for breakfast with your favorite fruit. And then for dinner, you can eat whatever you want that's cheap. It doesn't have to be 100% perfectly clean. But there you have it. That's meal prep on a budget. I work on a budget, quite honestly, because I pay close to $1,600 a month in child support being divorced. So I have to watch my money. So every Sunday, I go to the grocery store. I buy Greek yogurt. I buy eggs. I buy a protein pancake mix. I buy a cheap meat, a couple fruits, a couple vegetables. Boom, I'm done. That's it. I can get out of the grocery store for like $30, have food for the entire week. And the only variable outside of that is what I'm having for dinner. And I got to be honest, a lot of times if I'm in a rush and don't feel like cooking, I'll go over to McDonald's and get 3 McDoubles for like $3.50. And you can get like 70 grams of protein for $3.50, and you got some burgers. So that's another cheap little tip that I have. So I hope this video has been of help, Mars. It's really not that complicated if you stick to the type of diet that I eat. Throw a couple fruits and vegetables in each day in your meal prep or in your Greek yogurt. You get a little micronutrient variety, and you really save a lot of money. I don't have a lot of carbs in this mix. You probably noticed, because I am a low carb eater. But if you want to add carbs into this mix, you can get a bag of potatoes. You can get a 10-pound bag of rice for dirt cheap, and just throw a cup or two into your crock pot meal prep. Or you can get a big thing of oatmeal as well and toss that in with your Greek yogurt. So it's really not hard to add carbohydrates to that mix. You can also add my post-workout product, Huge Gainer, which is only $24.99. That has 25 grams of protein and 75 grams of carbs for only $24.99. That's a perfect post-workout shake. So if you're looking for something post-workout that has carbs, you can go that route as well. So guys, hope this video has been of some help. If you have any questions or comments, drop them below. If you've made it this far in this video and have yet to subscribe to my channel, please do. I'd appreciate the support. So guys, as always, thanks for watching. Have a great day.